And the key thing is that they do realize that China now is not the country it was 30 years ago when Deng Xiaoping launched them on these reforms. It has to be responsive to international pressure. It has to participate in the international system in a way it never used to before. You know, China used to be a poor country, as it was seen, and it could get away with a lot. People would forgive it of a lot. Mm. Today, it's the world's second largest economy. It's expected to play an active role in issues like Iran, North Korea. And Xi Jinping is a much more, in his own way, much more sensitive politician than his predecessors were. He gets that. If you see him in the crowd in Los Angeles watching a baseball game, yeah, he almost looks like a plausible participant in the politics we know.
And had some experience in America, too.
He did. He went to Iowa when he was a young Communist Party member and spent some time there.
So there are only seven members which rule the country.
There's
seven
nine now, and they're
the
likely
standing committee.
That's
nine,
right.
And they're going to reduce it to seven.
Yeah, that's
why
the expectation. Well, part of the idea is that the leadership has gotten diffused across so many people. There are now so many different voices in the room running this country that it's almost impossible to get anything done, which sounds funny to us in America because, of course, we think of China as getting things done efficiently. But one of the things that they've done is they have not taken the steps of economic reform that people want them to take. Reduce the role of the state-owned enterprises, and boost consumption, get away from the old model. So they're trying to
favoritism towards state-owned enterprise versus private-owned enterprise, according to people from China who come here who own Chinese private companies.
Yeah, that's right. It's a very hard place to be a private entrepreneur.
Right.
50% of the economy, more or less, is dominated by the state-owned enterprises. If you look at the Fortune 500 list, the Chinese companies that are on there, at least 30 out of those 50 that are on there are state-owned enterprises.
And two of the Chinese banks are two of the largest banks in the world.
Exactly. And so what they want to do is to go from the old state capitalism model to a model that promotes entrepreneurship, promotes innovation, and can get them out of this middle-income trap. That's the challenge facing this.
And serve domestic demand rather than export demand.
Exactly. They need to get, they've got this enormous market that they need to unleash. But in order to unleash it, it doesn't just mean telling people to go out and buy. It means you have to figure out a way to move money from these very, very rich state-owned enterprises into the pockets of ordinary consumers. That means liberalizing the banking system. It means taking some very hard choices.
Join us online at charlierose.com.